In the last 10 or 15 years, there's been a lot of good work done on emotional intelligence and leadership. And by emotional intelligence, I mean first self-awareness, so that you can sense the emergence of feelings, positive and negative, in their first moments. Second, that you can manage yourself and channeling your emotions in a constructive way. But there's also an outward-facing aspect of emotional intelligence, and that's understanding other people's feelings and knowing how to respond to them in a way that helps the relationship as opposed to stresses it. Emotional intelligence is also critically important in negotiation, and I'd say particularly so when the stakes are high for both sides. Years ago, the pioneering sports agent Donald Dell was in a meeting with the company that makes head tennis rackets. And his star client, Arthur Ashe, Wimbledon champion, U.S. Open champion, had endorsed head rackets. So they're having this meeting when suddenly the door bursts open and the chairman of the company bursts in, his face red, angry, and he says, "This is outrageous. Arthur Ashe is getting 10 times what I'm getting paid and I'm chairman of the company." Room went silent and everybody is looking at Donald Dell, seeing how he'll respond. Will he cave in? Will he respond in kind? He paused for a second and then kind of tilted his head and said with a smile, "But Pierre, Arthur has a much better serve than you do." Everybody took a deep breath. They relaxed. They got on with the conversation and salvaged a business relationship that was very important to both sides. Dell says, quote, "I live for such moments." Maybe you do too, but if so, you and Dell are exceptions. Even experienced veteran negotiators feel some level of anxiety in the course of negotiation. We found that there are several sources of it. One is that by definition in negotiation, you aren't in complete control of your destiny. Something that you want, something you're trying to get, depends on winning the assent of the person you're dealing with. So there's a great deal of uncertainty that can feed on self-doubt and insecurity. And the problem comes is that those really are disabling, because if we have some degree of self-doubt, some anxiety, we're likely to be defensive, we're likely to see the glass as being half empty, and others read our own guardedness as being hostile or not trustworthy. We want to look inward at ourselves in terms of our own worries and concerns. We want to find a way in which we can get emotionally in the right frame of mind for negotiation. But we also have to engage other people productively, and that means hearing not just what they're saying, but hearing what they're expressing in their body language, in their tone of voice. That's all part of emotional intelligence in negotiation. So, by all means, know the numbers well, know the market well. That's part of preparing for negotiation. But you also have to be emotionally intelligent if you want to be successful as a negotiator.